Outside the old city walls of Jerusalem here, very important site, because when Nebuchadnezzar and the Babylonians conquered Jerusalem, they sacked the city, destroyed the walls, brought them down to a pile of rubble, destroyed the temple, and led away all the able-bodied people into what's known as exile. They were force marched all the way around down to Babylon, far from home. There they sat down by the river, by the rivers of Babylon. You may have heard that song from a psalm that speaks about them weeping as they remembered Zion, the city of Jerusalem, now destroyed. Well, fast forward a few decades, and Nehemiah, one of the Israelites, one of the Hebrews, has been given a prominent position of power in Babylon. He hears that these walls are destroyed and he begins to weep. It says in the book of Nehemiah, as soon as I heard these words, I sat down and wept and I fasted and prayed. And he asked God to help restore the walls. And God basically said, why don't you be the answer to that prayer? To cut a long story short, Nehemiah says, the gracious hand of my God was upon me. He got incredible favor and resources, returned to Jerusalem and built up these walls. Many of these walls here, you can see, were built in the time of Nehemiah and then later periods of restoration as well. Behind me here, you can just see the dung gate. One of the families said, we'll fix the dung gate. What heroes when you prepare to fix the dung gate. Everyone mucked in and together they rebuilt the walls of Jerusalem. Most builders struggled to finish on time. Nehemiah and the builders of the wall had such favor, they finished in rapid time. And then along with Ezra, they worked to call God's people who'd been in exile back to the Torah. They celebrated the Passover, they recovered faithfulness to Yahweh here in the city of Jerusalem. Post-exile then, the walls were rebuilt, the temple was rebuilt, the nation was rebuilt, and they began to wait then for the promise of the Messiah who would come and bring ultimate restoration and hope. Nehemiah and the city of Jerusalem.